Hello and welcome everyone to the Environment Primer series of GISTIIS. My name is Pragya. As we all know, in our Environment Primer, we are discussing the major animal projects that have been undertaken by the Government of India to conserve the various species of animal. The title of our today's discussion is Project Rhino. In this discussion, we are going to talk about the protection and conservation of the great one-horned rhinosaurus species that is found exclusively in India. So, in this discussion, we are firstly going to study about the great one-horned rhino. Then we are also going to examine the threats, okay? And then we are also going to see the conservation efforts that have been taken by the Government of India. Then we are also going to study about the Kaziranga National Park. And lastly, we are going to see some of the important questions from the perspective of your prelims examination. So, if I talk about the background of our today's topic, we celebrate the World Rhino Day. World Rhino Day on 22nd September every year. 22nd September every year. And this World Rhino Day was founded by the WWF or the World Wildlife Fund in the year 2010 to increase the awareness amongst the people about the protection and conservation of rhinoceros. Apart from this, the State of the Rhino Report has also been released. State of the Rhino Report 2023 has also been released, and it has actually evidenced the fact that yes, the conservation efforts are actually helping the rhinoceros, and if we try to increase these positive conservation efforts, definitely the population of the all five species of rhinoceros, all five species of rhinoceros will be rebound in the world, and they will be successfully protected and conservated. So, this brings us to the point of discussion of our today's session about the great one-horned rhinoceros that is exclusively found in India. Okay, so there are five species, as I have mentioned, of rhinoceros: white and black rhinos in Africa, the greater one-horned Javan and Sumatran rhino species in Asia. Okay. So, only the great one-horned rhino is found in India, as I have said, and also known as the Indian rhino, it is the largest of the rhino species. But if you realize and analyze the State of the Rhino Report 2023, what is happening in Africa is that the conservation efforts are there in the private hands. So, basically the government needs to interfere, and they also face a very large threat of poaching. Large threat of poaching. In Africa, okay. So, the scientists are arguing that yes, the government needs to interfere, because despite this large threat of poaching, they are striving in Africa. They are successfully striving in Africa, and that is why they are saying that yes, now increase the conservation efforts. So, this brings us to the protection status of these five species in the IUCN Red List of Species, okay. So, if you talk about the black rhino, that is critically endangered, and it is the smaller of the two African species. Then if you talk about the white rhino, it is near threatened. Researchers have created an embryo of the northern white rhino by using in vitro fertilization process, also known as IVF. Then there is one horned rhino, which is endemic to India. Endemic to India. It is in the category of vulnerable species. Then there is Javan rhinoceros, that is critically endangered. And then there is Sumatran rhinoceros, that is also critically endangered. Basically, it has gone extinct in Malaysia. So, this was the protection status of the rhinoceros, five species of rhinoceros all across the globe. Moving forward, as you can see, this is the one-horned rhino. You can see it has one horn on its forehead. Okay. And it is the species that is endemic to India. And if you talk about the protection status that has been granted to this species in India, IUCN red list, vulnerable as I have mentioned. Sites, appendix 1, and in the Indian Wildlife Protection Act, it has also the highest protection under Schedule 1. Moving forward. To the habitat of the great one horned rhino that is found in India. So basically the species is confined to a small habitat area in the Indo-Nepal Terai as well as the northern West Bengal and Assam. If you talk about the state of Assam, it is the inhabitor of the largest one horned rhino species. Rhinos are mostly found in Assam, as I have mentioned, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh in India. Pabitora Wildlife Reserve, Kaziranga National Park, Rajiv Gandhi Orang National Park and Manas National Park in Assam are the habitats to an estimated 2640 rhinos. Okay, so despite the threat of loss of habitat, we have been able to increase the number of rhinoceros to around 4000 from the year 1985, and this has been mentioned in the state of the rhino report. Rhino report 2023, and this data has also been confirmed by conducting a rhino census. So yes, we have successfully increased the number of the rhinoceros. Moving forward, let us examine the threats that are there to the population of the rhinoceros and why are they completely not in the safe zone. Okay, so firstly, poaching remains the single largest threat to the population of the rhinoceros all across the globe. It is so much so a big threat that the Assam government officials had to burn around 2,500 horns to increase the awareness about the poaching of the horns. They are saying that no, you are just assuming that they are beneficial for medicinal purposes or Chinese medicine, but they have no fruitful purpose. You are just killing innocent rhinoceros for your own selfish needs. So yes, poaching remains the biggest threat for the population of the rhinoceros. Then there is habitat loss, not only because of the human activities, but also because of climate change. Okay, so climate change is real, as we have discussed in our Environment Primer series, and not only the humans are facing the brunt of climate change, the animals are also facing the brunt of climate change, and definitely they are suffering habitat loss, because you might have heard in the news as well that the Kaziranga National Park was recently very flooded and it is a home to a large number of rhinoceros. Okay, so there is a need to protect not only the species per se but also their habitats. Then there is lack of population density. The population density is definitely decreasing. Then there is decreasing genetic diversity among the species of rhinoceros. Moving forward, let us analyze the conservation efforts undertaken by the Government of India to protect and preserve the species of rhinoceros that is found in India, that is the great one horned rhino. Okay, so firstly, there is Project Rhino. This Project Rhino is famously known as the India's Rhino Vision 2020. So basically, this project ended in 2020 and it was a partial success. Okay, so launched in 2005, Indian Rhino Vision 2020, as the official name is Indian Rhino Vision 2020, was an ambitious effort to attain a wild population of at least 3000 greater one-horned rhinos spread over 7 protected areas in the Indian state of Assam by the year 2020. So basically the main aim of the project was to increase the population plus successful translocation. So This was the main aim of behind the launch of this Project Rhino or the India's Rhino Vision of the year 2020. So let us examine the success or the failure of the projects, on what ground it was a success and on what ground it did not achieve a complete success. Okay. So seven protected areas under this project are Kaziranga, Pobitora, Orang National Park, Manas National Park, Lau Khova Wildlife Sanctuary, Buracha Pori Wildlife Sanctuary and Dibru Saikhova Wildlife Sanctuary. So all of these were seven areas that were considered in the Project Rhino. So wild-to-wild translocations were an essential part of IRV 2020, moving rhinos from densely populated parks like Kaziranga, NP to ones in need of more rhinos like Manas National Park. Okay. So basically, as I have explained that yes, the project had two basic aims, increasing the population and successful translocation. So seven protected areas were reserved for the project, and definitely it had a successful translocation as one of its aims, because we have seen the threat of loss of population density. So we also paid the attention to increasing the population density in those areas which were suffering from the loss of population density. Okay, moving forward. So the target of attaining a population of 3000 rhinos was almost achieved, but the animal could be reintroduced in only one of the four protected areas that were planned. So on the ground of increase of population, the project was successful, as we have conducted a latest census and we have found that yes, we have successfully increased the number to 4000 from the, if we calculate it from the year, and if we see it from the year 1985. So yes, the project was successful on that ground, but it was a partial success on the ground of reintroduction of the species in the seven protected areas. Seven protected areas, and could be reintroduced in just one protected area. So on this ground, the project was a partial success. The translocated rhinos helped Manas National Park get back its World Heritage Site status in 2011. And definitely this means a lot if we are trying to increase our positive actions, positive conservation actions. Okay. And in 2018 and 2019 saw significant decreases in poaching. The results of forestry, local and national government officials coordinating efforts to combat wildlife crime across the state of Assam. And you will be pleased to know that in the year 2022, Assam reported almost zero poaching cases. However, one case was reported in the year 2023. So yes, poaching is our single biggest threat, and definitely we are working towards decreasing the poaching activities. Moving forward to the Delhi Declaration on Asian Rhinos 2019. So the five rhino range nations, India, Bhutan, Nepal, Indonesia and Malaysia, have signed a declaration, namely the New Delhi Declaration on Asian Rhinos 2019, for the conservation and protection of the rhinoceros species. So as you can see, the countries are not only conserving and protecting the species on a national level, they are coming together to protect and conserve the species on an international level as well. And that is why this 2019 New Delhi Declaration was signed. Moving forward, there is a project to create DNA profiles of all rhinos. And this project was successfully launched in the year 2016. And the nodal ministry is, can you guess it? Yes, your guess is right. The nodal ministry is Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change. So the RODIS or the Rhino DNA Index System is a wildlife forensics tool that was specially developed for investigating wildlife crime cases. And this has helped in a successful decrease in the poaching, okay, because we are tracking the DNA profile of rhinoceros, and we are also being able to find out that yes, the poachers, the actual poachers who are behind the poaching of the rhinoceros. So definitely this is a very ambitious project that has been launched by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Moving forward, let us talk about the Kaziranga National Park. So currently 85% of the world's one horned rhino population is concentrated in Assam, and I have mentioned that yes, Assam is the largest inhabitor of the one horned rhino species, okay, with 65% of the population being found in the Kaziranga National Park, Assam. And this Kaziranga National Park is very important to us. It has been awarded the status of national park in the year 1974, then the status of UNESCO World Heritage Site. In the year 1985, and it has also been declared as a tiger reserve. Tiger reserve in the year 2007. So this Kaziranga National Park is very important to us, and in fact we cite the conservation model that is being followed by the Kaziranga National Park in another conservation models also, in another animal projects also. So the much of the focus of the conservation efforts in Kaziranga are focused on the big four species, that is rhino, elephant, Royal Bengal tiger and the Asiatic water buffalo. So this national park is very important to us. Now let us discuss the previous practice question which I have asked in my previous session, and I said that yes, I will reveal the answer in my next session. So, because we have concluded our discussion for today, we have seen what are the great one-horned rhinos. We have also examined their threats, habitats, protection status, conservation efforts, etc. So, now let us discuss this previous practice question which I have asked in my previous discussion. So, the question was, consider the following statements regarding sea turtles. Your option 1 was, they are cold-blooded species. Your option 2 was, Gahir Matha Marine Sanctuary is a marine wildlife sanctuary in Odisha that is home to the world's largest nesting beach for olive ridley turtles. So, which of the statements given above is our correct? Your options were, option A was 1 only, option B was 2 only, option C was both 1 and 2, and option D was neither 1 nor 2. So, the correct answer is going to be option C. Both statements 1 and 2 are correct. Now let us discuss some of the important questions from our today's discussion. So the question is, with reference to the one-horned rhino, consider the following statements. Statement number 1, it is categorized as endangered in the IUCN Red List. And statement number 2 is, it is the only species of rhino found in India. So which of these statements given above is our correct? Your options are, option A is 1 only, option B is 2 only, option C is both 1 and 2, and option D is neither 1 nor 2. So, your correct answer is going to be option 2 only, because as I have mentioned that they are vulnerable and not endangered on the IUCN Red List of Species. Now, let us discuss the last question of our today's discussion. So, the question is, consider the following statements. Your statement number 1 is, the one-horned rhinoceros is rhino species native to the Indian subcontinent. Your statement number 2 is, it is listed as critically endangered on the IUCN Red List. Your statement number 3 is, it mainly breeds in the terai grasslands of northern India. So, which of the given statements is our correct? Your options are, option A 1, 2 and 3, option B only 1, option C 1 and 2, and option D is 1 and 3. So, this answer will be given by you to me in the comment box below. I hope this session was insightful for you. If you have any feedback regarding this session, you can drop it in the comment box. If you liked the today's discussion and found it to be helpful, kindly like the video and subscribe to our channel for more such interesting updates. Thank you.
For more informative content, like, share and subscribe. And do not forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications.